Making 3D games in GDevelop just got easier with these extensions. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a 3D tank shooter game in GDevelop 5. So I've decided to make this a multiplayer game. So in this part of the tutorial, we'll focus on making a 3D game, and in the next part, we'll focus on implementing the multiplayer. So if you're not subscribed yet, you should consider subscribing so you do not miss the next video. Okay, so before we begin the tutorial, I will leave a link in the description of this video where you can download this project at its current state and you can follow along with the tutorial. So you can pause this video right now, download the templates in the link below and follow along. So first off, we have our tank object. Our tank object is a 3D object and uses a stylized tank.jlb file in it. So here we have our X axis and our Z axis rotated to 90, so that should fit the orientation we want our tank to be. Okay, and next we have our walls. Now our walls is the maze which you saw in the preview earlier, and in here we have the X axis of our walls object rotated to 90. Right, next we have a new 3D box. So this is the flow of our game. This is going to show an image on its front face, which is the ground image. Here we go. Next we have our block. Now block object serves one purpose in our game, which is for collision. So in here you can see we have this black object all around the maze. So this is our collision object. So next we have the bullet object, which is what our tank object will shoot. So we have our bullets. And in here we have it rotated to minus 90 on its Z axis. And finally we have our red explosion, which is the explosion you see once the bullet is in collision with the walls, or in this case our block object. So with this, let's go into our project manager and take a look at all the extensions we'll be using for this. So in here we have our project manager and we have four extensions right here. The first is a fire bullet. We're going to use this fire bullet from the tank. Next, we have a particle emitter 3D, which we're going to use for our red explosion. And this extension comes with our red explosion object. So as soon as you add the 3D particle emitter object, it's going to add this extension for you. Next, we have our warp 3D. We're going to use this extension to move our tank in the direction we want it to move in. And finally, we have our third person camera. So this is going to look at our tank object from the rotation and elevation we want it to be. So with this, let's go into our events. Now the first thing we need to do is handle movement. So let's add a new event group, and in here let's name this move. Let's add an event in our group, and the first condition we're going to check for is if a key is pressed. For this game, we're going to use WASD, where W is going to serve as the up direction, D is going to serve as the right direction, S is going to serve as the down or backwards, and we're going to set A for our left direction. So let's add a condition. Let's check for pressed. Now key pressed, and let's start with our forward, which is W. So once we press W key, let's add an action. Let's select our tank. Now, as you can see, we don't have the actions here. That's because we've not attached this behavior to our tank object. So to do that, let's cancel. Let's go into our stats. Let's select our tank object. Let's go into behaviors, and you need to add the behavior. It should be the 3D walk behavior. So let's add this in, and in here you can customize it to what you want. You can set the acceleration, deceleration, just like you do with the platformer character behavior. But this will be going with all the default values because I think this is okay. Apply, scene events. Let's add an action. Let's select our tank object and let's simulate move forward key press. Here we go. Okay. And I'm going to copy this, copy and paste it. Next, let's check if S key is pressed. This should move backwards. And for this, we change the action to simulate move backward key press. Once again, let's paste. We have this here. We need to drag this down. And now let's check for our D key. Once D key is pressed, we need it to rotate to the right. So here we have two actions which look almost similar. We have simulate turn right key press, and we have simulate move right key press. The move right key press is going to move to the right direction, while the turn right is going to rotate it in the right direction. So let's select this. Okay, and finally let's paste. Now let's check if A key is pressed. Once A key is pressed, we need this to move or to turn in the left direction, not move but on in the left direction. So with this, we can preview our game and we don't have a tank object in the scene. And that's a quick fix. Let's go back into our scene editor and let's drag our tank objects into the scene. Now, if we preview this, you should see our tank object right there. I'm currently pressing S on my keyboard. It's going backwards. I'm pressing W and it's going forward. So if I press D, it should rotate towards the right. Here we go. And if I press A, it should rotate towards the left. And there we go. Okay, so now we have our tank object moving outside camera bounds. So what we need to do here is make the camera follow our tank object. So let's close our preview. Let's go into our scene events. Let's add a new events group. And in here, let's name this cam. Let's add a sub-event in this group, an action. And for this, we'll be making use of the third-person camera extension, which I showed you earlier. So let's search up camera and let's look for it. So here we go. Look at an object from a distance. So our object is going to be our tank object. The distance is going to be 1,000. The rotation, I'm going to set this to 50. The elevation is going to be 50. And we hit OK. So if we preview this, so as you can see now, we have our camera following our tank object. There we go. Now, if you notice, we have our tank object can go through our maze. Now we need to fix this, and this is a very quick fix. So for this, we can make use of an action to separate our block object and our tank object. So let's go into our events. Let's add a new events group and I'll call this collision. Let's add an event in there and let's add an action. For this, we'll search for the separate object and let's select tank, and the object that will move will be our block object. Okay, so if we preview this now, you see, we can no longer go through our maze. There we go. At this point, we can also hide our block object. So let's add an action. Let's select block. Let's set hide. And if we update this, here we go. So we have our block object hidden now. And our tank can no longer go through our maze. It's time we create our shooting mechanics. So once the key is pressed, we want our tank object to shoot a bullet. So to do this, let's close. Okay, so let's add a new events group and let's call this shoot. So in here, let's add a new event in there. Let's add a condition to check if a key is released. So let's say key released. And for this, I'll be using my F key. So once F key is released, let's add an action to shoot our bullets. Now it's not going to show here because we've not attached that behavior to our tank object. So let's go back into our stats and let's select tank. Let's go into behaviors and let's add a behavior. So it should be the fire bullets behavior. So once you add this, you can go ahead and customize this. But for this, I'll be going with the default values. So let's apply this. Let's go into our events, and in our events, let's add an action, select our tank object, and let's say fire bullets towards an angle. The X position will be our tank center. The Y position will be our tank center Y. The bullet object is going to be bullets. The angle, we're going to make use of our tank angle as its direction. And the speed, I'll set this to 1000. Okay, so with this, this should shoot the bullet now. Let's also add our explosion. So for that, let's add a new event. Let's add a condition. Our condition is going to check for a collision between bullets and our block. So if there's a collision, let's create red explosion at the bullet center X and the bullet center Y. And we also need to customize the Z elevation or the Z position of our red explosion and our bullets. So for that, let's add an action in here. Our action, we're going to select bullets. Let's search for Z position. Here we go. And we're going to set this to 53. Let's do the same for our red explosion. I'll copy this. Let's place it here. And let's change this to red explosion. And finally, once there's a collision between bullet and block, we need to delete our bullet object. And there we go. So if we preview this, we have our tank. Once I press F on my keyboard, so you can see it shoots out the bullet, which can also be called a shell, but I will call it a bullet. And here we go. So with that, we have successfully created our 3D game and we have this working. So in the next part of this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can make this a multiplayer game where multiple users can join and you can play against them. I mean, there we're going to cover creating lobbies, we're going to cover joining games, and we will also cover displaying the player's name and their health on the player. So if you want to see this video, don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notifications so you do not miss it once it is out. I'll also leave a link in the description to the video once it's out, so you can click on that and continue the tutorial. So if you found this useful, as always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share. I'll see you guys in my next tutorial.